Extend a warm welcome to the McCall graduating class this evening, and to their parents and guardians, their friends and relatives, and to the McCall faculty and staff joining us here as well. And to Winchester School Committee member and school chair, Mrs. Cindy Boney, who will be assisting me in the distribution of graduation certificates. And thank you, Ms. Subak, guidance counselor, and Ms. Lavoy and Ms. West, assistant principals, will also be assisting with the presentation of certificates. Our featured staff speaker this evening, as voted by our graduating class, is Ms. Allie Matthews, and our featured student speaker, as nominated and voted by our graduating class, is Shreya Nair. Special thanks to a large committee of parents who worked extraordinarily hard to organize all of our end-of-year events. I wish to thank all committee members working together to create these wonderful opportunities and events for our students. A large committee of parents led by Heather Harris and Gina Mahoney worked hard to organize all of these events. The eighth grade committee chairs for fundraising were Heather Harris and Gina Mahoney. Graduation dance co-chairs were Jackie Mather and Caroline Kinsborn. Graduation ceremony co-chairs were Laura McGough and Jenny Albanese, and Canopy Lake co-chairs were Carrie Campbell and Michelle Crawford. Thank you all for working together to create these wonderful events for our students. I would also like to thank our custodians and the DPW for all their efforts in preparing for this event. Mr. Jay Gill, Mr. Pete Lawson, Mr. Paul Fay, Mr. Phil Doucette, Mr. Steve Cannon, Mr. Given Jean-Baptiste, Mr. Vincent Toland, and our head custodian, Mr. Dan Doucette. Tonight's program is dedicated to Ms. Lori Schmidt for her 30 years of service, Ms. Carol Weir for her 24 years of service, Ms. Lainey Higgins for her 20 years of service, Ms. Rebecca Jacques for her 20 years of service, Ms. Diana Deering for her 20 years of service, and Ms. Molly Marsh for her last years of service to the students and community of Winchester. We're as happy as we are sad that you will be retiring this year. It is a happy time because we're so proud of what you've accomplished and are glad that each of you will finally have time to relax and enjoy life. It is a sad time because it is never easy to have to say goodbye to such wonderful educators and colleagues. Our entire family and community will miss you greatly. We wish you and your family good health and much happiness in your retirement. Thank you. Three of our retirees are with us this evening, and at this time I would like to invite yearbook committee members Layla Ladd and Isabel Kinsborn to the stage. They will be announcing this year's yearbook dedication and recognizing our retiring staff who are present this evening. Layla and Isabel, could you please come to the podium?
True teacher is every sense dedicated to her students, creative, fair, imaginative, resourceful, and intelligent. Original, formally trained English teacher, she switched to science and transformed the sixth grade science curriculum from the beginning. Laura is the founder and director of the Cool Science Club, leader of the community science service club, and greenhouse builder. Her strength and differences instruct and assimilate enrich her mentors and other teachers. We honor a colleague who truly inspired and gave freely of her time to whoever needed her.
Dedication to Miss Weir. A teacher held in the highest regard because she is so knowledgeable in her field and has a lifetime of experience. Carol shares a priceless gift, a love of reading. This is a gentle and gracious teacher whose positive influence has helped so many. In her special way, Carol has reached and furthered the journey of so many students who needed help with reading. Being conscious, truthful, and direct with parents garner her much respect. Student as schoolers has long been an avid interest with her. There are few like her. She will be missed. Dedication to Ms. Jackies. Thank you, Ms. Jackies, for your 20 years of service to the McCall community. As a guidance counselor, you have worked with countless students and families throughout your career. Thank you for trying to figure out every day how to manage the needs of so many children. You have consistently modeled for us all patience and kindness. Thank you for always being there for us. Many tears will be shed when we say goodbye at the end of the year, realizing that we will never find your equal.
Lainey, Carol, and Becky, could you come to the podium to receive a wrapped retirement gift? At this time, I would like to invite to the podium Christine Nguyen and Daniel Zhu, school council members and our student representatives on the McCall School Council, to the podium to present the class gift from the class of 2020 to the McCall Middle School. Daniel, Christine.
My name is Daniel Zhu, and this is Christine Nguyen. Together, we served as grade 8 representatives on the school council here at McCall. We worked together with members of the administration, teachers, parents, and local business owners to better the community of our school. In 2013, we entered McCall from different neighborhoods, playgrounds, and elementary schools. We were a lot shorter and even more nervous than we are now. Tonight, we leave as a unified class, ready to take on a bigger adventure, high school. We would like to leave a token of gratitude for the McCall community that we have enjoyed being a part of for 3 years.
We are pleased to announce that through fundraising and the generosity of our friends and families, the class of 2016 is able to provide the school with much needed wireless microphones that will be used to benefit the students of McCall for many years. On behalf of our class, we would like to thank all of our teachers and the staff and administration here at McCall for a truly wonderful middle school experience.
The next item on the agenda in our program is the presentation of the Evander French Jr. Humanitarian Award. In 2010, the McCall Parents Association inaugurated the Evander French Jr. Humanitarian Award to recognize two students, one boy and one girl in grade 8, who have answered the call to improve and enrich the lives of others. The award honors Vandy French, principal of McCall for 26 years from 1984 to 2010, whose vision and efforts built a community of learners and leaders who reflect his values of excellence, respect, and equity. The winners will be receiving a certificate today and will also have their names inscribed on an award plaque, which will be located outside the main office. At this time, I would like to invite Superintendent Evans to the podium to present this year's recipients of the Evander French Jr. Humanitarian Awards.
This year's recipients of the Evander French Jr. Humanitarian Award are Matthew Suffredini and Sophie Farnhill.
Thank you. At this time, I would like to invite Miss Matthews, if she's ready, to the podium. Each year, graduating students select a faculty or staff member to be the featured speaker. I'm glad to see that Miss Matthews could be honored in this way after her years of service to this community and the wonderful rapport she builds with students every year. Please join me in welcoming Miss Matthews to the podium.
Thank you, Superintendent Dr. Evans, School Committee Chair Ms. Boney, Principal Mr. Gonsalves, Assistant Principals Mrs. West and Ms. Lavoie, the 8th grade graduation committee, faculty and staff members, and friends and families of our 8th grade graduates. These students are here because of your love and support. Most of all, thank you to the class of 2020. You are hands down the best class I have ever taught. And I have heard many, yes. Thanks, I needed a break there. And I've heard many of our more veteran teachers here at McCall say the same. And if there is an older sibling in the audience, I promise that we love your class too, we do. But I have to say, these students have you beat. I am honored, sorry, it's true. I am honored, humble, and grateful to get to address you today because I have so much I want to say. This year, school has been a safe haven for me, and I hope that is true for you too. There is so much negativity, so many challenges happening outside of our classroom spaces that being with you, processing it all with you has been a gift. To be clear, I desperately wish that the tragedies of this year hadn't entered our safe spaces in the first place. Attacks by hate-filled individuals, a global refugee crisis, continued challenges surrounding issues of race, and disheartening, divisive political rhetoric. Yet this is our shared reality. And the thoughtful, generous way you have reflected upon these issues restores my hope daily. You are some of the best, most thoughtful people I have ever known. And because I can also add hardworking, you give us incredible hope. Please, as we mark this next official step into your adulthood, please continue to be at least as respectful, tolerant, and accepting as you have been here. In fact, I challenge you to be even more so because our world needs for you to be. Stand up for yourself, stand up for others. We are asking a lot of you, we know, and at a time when it is particularly hard to be a kid. There is a lot of stress and a lot of pressure. I know this not only from my role as a teacher, but also in my role as a parent. Maybe this is because it feels as if you are all competing for fewer resources, or because the economic truth that being middle class is no longer without struggle. Maybe your parents, and I include myself here, maybe our own self-worth and accomplishments as parents has become increasingly more wrapped up in the perceived successes of you all. How many honors classes you will be taking, or if and where you will one day end up going to college, I don't know. But I think this often translates to you in really negative ways. Too often you come to understand that your personal achievements are perceived as being valued over your kindness, that what defines you is not who you are, but what you have achieved. And if this message is being communicated to you, I apologize on behalf of all of the adults here. That would be our great mistake. Know that your final grade in any subject is not what defines you, and it will never, ever be more important than the person you are becoming. Neither being a parent of a teenager nor being a teenager is easy, and throughout the year, I found myself reminding students and reminding parents that the love is there. We wouldn't all be assembled here together now if it were not. And just as this is a student's first time being a teenager, most parents haven't really done this before, and it's hard to be great at something you're only doing for the first time. Please keep finding patience with and for one another. I am so grateful when my Mads and Hens find patience for me. I used to think that I just wanted for my kids to be happy, but I actually have changed my mind on that. To me, that's a pretty low bar. That's not what I want for my own children, and that's not what I want for you all either. I guess, yes, ultimately, it would be great if you were all happy. I don't dismiss it. But what I want most for you is for you to be kind, to think outside of yourselves, to understand that you have responsibilities not just to shine academically or athletically or musically, but that you have responsibilities to your families and to your community. When you are 14, this is often demonstrated in really mundane ways. Emptying the dishwasher, for example. So do it, and do it without being asked. And because the big secret is, and what I think we as grown-ups sometimes forget, or that we as a society have somehow lost, is that ultimately, it is the fulfillment of these responsibilities that will bring you happiness. This is because being responsible for and to others is what connects us. And those connections are what bring us happiness. Just shining alone will never get any of us anywhere. In fact, shining alone makes us only anxious and afraid. There are lots of things that take you out of these responsibilities. Sometimes your parents, your teachers, I do unwittingly, and sometimes we simply don't demand this commitment from you because you don't have the time, because you're too busy developing the things that will make you shine. There is that, and there is another culprit, the technology. The technology promotes a kind of isolationism and narcissism that can be toxic and misguiding. Please know that I'm an early adapter, and I have it all around me. And I have allowed my students to have it all around them because fundamentally, the technology is not only good, it is essential. However, we all also must manage the technology rather than allowing the technology to manage us. Only my students know my daughter's Snapchat score. And she would kill me if I told you. But what is heartening is that she recently admitted as she was searching for a picture of herself and a friend, one that she could post for her friend's birthday, she admitted that how she looked in the picture wasn't really important. It was a watershed moment. And the number of likes? Don't be tricked into believing that is truly important. It isn't, I promise you. And if the number of likes is low, it really doesn't matter. Don't take your post down. Don't let other people define your value in this way. The stories that go up are just that, stories, moments. Don't let these pictures be who you are, and in the same way, Don't be tricked into believing that someone else's life is the sum of their posts. There is more to all of us than that. Finally, in addition to teaching and parenting kids in this crazy world, in this pressurized environment, with all of this technology, our community lost Kira this year. And in keeping with my thread, this too made my year really hard. And I cannot close without acknowledging it. In recent years, as a community, we have been broken by the loss of young lives. These were students who were in our classes, walked our halls, sat where you are sitting today. They were here, only now they're not, and our lives move on just without them. Again, as you take this next step into adulthood, there will be choices you will be asked to make, risky choices. And navigating all of this can be really good. You'll have chances to develop your moral compass and prove too that you are better than your teenage brains. And it will be the job of the people in this community to work to keep you safe until you are old enough and smart enough to realize how to keep yourself safe. And as you are teenagers, you will mess up, because that's how you learn. You just can't mess up too badly. Be responsible. Think outside of yourselves. Because what I have been trying to say here is that your life isn't just about you. It is about more than just yourselves. Your choices affect you first, but don't think for one second that your choices don't extend beyond that, far, far beyond that. And if this life becomes too much and you find yourself losing your way and you need support, get it. You are not alone in this world. No matter how strong that feeling may seem, or how often you feel that way. Another secret? Sometimes we all feel that way. So I have one more request of you, our students. Look up at the bleachers, at the people in front of you, the people in the chairs in front of you. Look along the fence, all the way down the fence. Turn to see the faculty who are here to support you, and look around at the 370 plus eighth grade graduates seated here today. Know that this is your community, and recognize that you are responsible, we are responsible for one another and to one another, for always, for keeps. And you're not allowed to leave this earth before your parents and your teachers do. Don't go. Well, okay, go. You know what I mean. Go to high school. Live, love, study, achieve. Achieve in the traditional sense, but achieve too in the ways that will make you happy and connected to others, which is to be kind. Be ridiculously kind. It is easy to say that people should have done more for Friedrich, for Elie Wiesel, for Melba Beals, for Kino, or for Ponyboy even. But it is hard to see these failures in front of us and in ourselves. On a larger scale, we wonder what we can do about the challenges facing our country and our world today. What can we do? We can ask ourselves, am I doing enough for the outsider? Am I doing enough for the person sitting next to me? I don't know if I am, but I will spend the rest of my days trying, because that is the meaning of everything. This year, the students in my homeroom decided that I might have a little bit of separation anxiety. Ms. Hebda, I'm sorry that the beginning of the alphabet was always late from homeroom to your third floor, first period science class. I really am sorry. It's just that every morning I had a really hard time letting them go. And now I have to let you go. We all have to let you go. So, mow the lawn, fold the laundry, put your phones down, make responsible choices, and make each considering how your choices will affect all of us. Get help when you need it, and be kind. Most of all, be kind. I'll say goodbye to you the way each day I said goodbye in homeroom. Love you, bye. Love you, bye. Love you, love you, love you, bye. Love you.
At this time, I would like to invite Shreya Nair to the podium. This is the first time that we've ever had a student selected, but we just told you how wonderful this class was, and we couldn't miss this opportunity to change the program a little bit and invite one of the members of the class to speak. So Shreya.
Good afternoon, friends, faculty, family, and my spectacular classmates! How are you all doing tonight? Awesome. Wow. Wow! Class of McCall Middle School, 2016. If we could thank every person who helped us get through these crazy, weird 3 years of my life, our lives, I know we would. But Mr. Gonzales only gave me 5 minutes, so I can only go through the big ones. Thank you, YouTube, Wikipedia, and Google. Thank you so much, Google. So much. In all seriousness, there are so many people I would like to thank right now, including those who made giving this speech possible. For Mr. Gonzales and the rest of our McCall school, our McCall Middle School administration, to all the graduates out in the wings here, to my awesome parents, grandparents, sister, and back. I want to thank all of the teachers I've had this year, and the last two. Thank you, Ms. Kennedy, for letting me borrow a Chromebook every single day five. Thank you, Ms. Hebda, for bearing with my relentlessly bad mineral puns. Thank you, Ms. Campbell, for being an inhumanly strong teacher and mother. Thank you, Senora Arena and Mr. Van Dinter, for being the most hilarious and fun teachers I've ever had. Woo! Thank you, Ms. Matthews and Ms. Walker, for helping me write this speech. Most of all, I want to thank you. It is instinct for us to be there for one another, to help one another. From math problems to more complex issues around friends and family and just being a teenager. Thank you for being the kickstand to each other's bicycles, to my bicycle. Like this, we made it through 3 years of middle school. That's 3,780 hours, or 226,800 minutes, or 13,608,000 seconds. Credits to Mr. Ferrelli for the math. 3 years of weekdays in this sturdy brick building. For 3 years, we've grown and we've learned, I hope. A lot of things have happened in 3 years. We made new friends. We lost some. We've learned and loved and lived and laughed. Trends have come and gone. We've worn our fair share of rainbow looms, believe me. And we've laughed at more than enough memes from Grumpy Cat to Dat Boy. Don't even get me started on all the water bottles we've flipped. Like, damn, Daniel. Of course we remember What the Fox Says. And, oh, who could ever forget? Excuse me for a second. Achoo! These 3 years, a lot of things happened. I remember the crowds around the theater for the release of the new Star Wars movie. And I know you all remember the dress. Oh, the dress. I still think it's blue and black. I also do think it's time we let it go, let it go.
Time is a weird concept.
Do you use hours and minutes? Trends? How about looking at where the sun is in the sky? Which I know is bothering all of you audience members right about now. How about the number of Pokemon battles you fight? The number of mozzarella sticks you eat? iPhones cracked? When we first entered this school, Moving Up Day, 2013, we were chubby-faced, tiny, giggling fifth graders yammering on about how great and scary and exciting middle school would be. Now, we gather here for our last time as eighth graders, and we can reflect upon how we have changed for the better. We've learned a lot more about a lot more things. Ourselves, our society, our friends, and the War of 1812. We take with us our memories, friends, our newfound independence, and everything there is to know about the adiabatic cooling of clouds, which, by the way, was not even on the final. Come on. We know this school like the back of our hands. All its secret stairs and rooftop entries and water fountains. But now, our time here at McCall is up. Except not entirely. With the 3 years of our adolescence spent at this school, we've, to say the least, done some stuff. Now, we're moving on, with a backpack chock full of middle school experiences. We're moving on to the next chapter in our lives, together. And believe me, we are ready. McCall, you've meant a lot to me. You've meant a lot to us. Thank you for everything.
Always so embarrassing when the students write better than the principal. At this time, we will be presenting the graduation certificates to the class of 2020 and the McCall class of 2016. Ms. Lavoy will be reading each student's name this evening, and I would ask that you hold your applause until each section is called. So we will be calling all of our students' last names A through K first, then we can apply. Hoot, holler, whistle. Then we will give the certificates to our students' last name L through L through Z, and then we can hoot, holler, and clap. Okay, so without further ado, let us get into distribution mode.
Rena Abinot. Julius Ahmad, Ian Albanese, Ella Aldridge, Kenesha Altador, Caroline Ampey, Michael Ampey, Adrian Anderson, Jenny Apostolis, Claire Artizani, Giuseppe Aurelio, Avery Badger, Ethan Balky, Sean Bannon, Marina Barilli, Jesse Basilier, Leah Batarse, Vicky Uzabashian. Adriana Bellani. Sophia Bertocci. Leon Bester. Celia Bianco. Stephanie Bianco. William Bix. Mia Billick. Maya Bode-Mather. Ariana Bonacorso. Michael Bongiorno. Nicholas Barretos. Meryl Bossy. Kayla Bossy. Charlotte Bradley. Seamus Brady. Isabel Reset. Majak Boy. Charlie Burbine. Lewis Burns. Ainsley Butler. Abby Byrne. Leah Cagnetta. Jennifer Calderon. Lucas Caffrey. Liam Campbell. Emma Campbell.
You're going up.
Kierce Canfield. Anna Carraza. Amelia Carlson. Sean Cashel. Cam Cassidy. Courtney Kavanaugh. Richard Centofanti. Elizabeth Cerullo. Cynthia Chang. Joey Shashaflian. Daniel Chen. Jace Christakis. Helen Chung. Selena Chung. Spencer Ciotti. Emily Clark. William Coakley. Kenzie Cogan. Kate Cohen. Lindsay Cohen. Sophia Colina. Caitlin Collins. Patrick Collins. Emily Conan. Odalise Cora. John Corby. Griffin Correa. Hannah Corso. Christopher Cortezes. Ian Costello. Cece Crawford. Isabelle Couteau. Kelsey Crotty. Caroline Cucinati. Lily Daly. Courtney Dalton. Maya Daniel. Kira Dower. Mia Day. Thomas Degnan. Himakshi Deka. Summer Della Sturgis. Joel DeLeone. Mark DeMichaelis. Megan Dennis. Tessa Dennis. Rhea Desai. David DeFranzo. William DeLeo. Gina Di Natale. Vivian Ding. Thomas Di Pietro. Joseph Dovalar. Jane Dodge. Patrick Daugherty. Haley Donato. Jack Donlin. Yeah. Peter Doughty. Emily Duval. Brooke Dowling. Trevor Drain. Mary Claire Dubard. Coleman Edwards. Christina Ellis. Kyle Edenhofer. Gregory Evans. Jacqueline Fallon. Asia Fairs. Sophie Farnhill. Lynn Farah. Karina Ferreira. Audrey Fitzgerald. Devin Fitzpatrick. Sarah Fitzpatrick. Liam Flanagan. Evan Forcucci. Hannah Friedman. Sophie Friedel. Colette Gagney. Isabella Galvin. Jessica Gao. Sam Garvey. Rifat Gouda. Isaac Raylan. Charles Green. Jeffrey Rear. Kristen Gressla. Nicholas Gressla. Kyle Rule. Julie Guerra. Michael Guo. Dasha Gurianova. John Guthrie. Ashley Hallowell. Dylan Hahn. Derek Harley. Spencer Harris. Kirsten Healy. Grace Heffernan. Daniel Henderson. Fiona Hughes. Grace Hyam. Abigail Hoffman. William Hoffines.
Yeah, William!
Adrian Pauly. Adam Horowitz. Nicole Hugh. Nicole Wang. Katie Wang. Jesse Wang. William Wang. Allison Hubner. Natalie Hughes. Cole Hudeman. Allison Hires. Emma Illich. Chris John Felix. Angel Jang. Sarah Johnston. Mia Yerkunis. Vivek Kandasamy. Aras Kaya. Elizabeth Kelly. Reed Kendall. Derek Kimball. Isabel Kinsborn. Kate Meebone. Peter Kamboris. Whitney Prayer.
Caitlin Lyons.
Mary McKay. Erin Madden. Elizabeth Mahoney. Connor Mahoney. Andrew Malloy. Daniel Malloy. Aria Manfred. John Paul Marino. Lucia Marino. Michael Martinetti. Woo! Mia Mituzzi. Frederick Mattis Roche. Woo! Nicole Mazzio. Grace McCafferty. Thomas McDonough. John McDonald. Kevin McGagan. Taylor McGough. Brooke McGurl. Anna McIntyre. Alex Medeiros. Gabriella Mistechkin. Arzu Miharia. Rachel Milt. Evan Mitsakis. Aiden Malloy. Alexander Moore. Denise Marova. Jackson Morrissey. Salvatore Muldrow.
Hey, Sam.
Elizabeth Morris. Chloe Munson. Colin Murphy. Colleen Murphy. Mia Murphy. Grant Murray. Mackenzie Murray. Andrew Murray. Shreya Nair. Robert New. Christine Nagujan. Simeon Nikov. Carolina Nishiyama. Will New. Joseph Norberg. Jonah Nowell. Sydney O'Callaghan. Courtney O'Connell. Owen O'Connor. Caroline O'Donnell. Brian Pacific. Rajan Pagan. Catherine Pala. Jenna Papagiannis. Christopher Parsons. Anna Pavlova. Samuel Peacock. Jake Pelusi. Alexander Philipchuk. Isabella Podoska. Diane Pomegas. Oliver Pullen. Cole Rebe.
Yahoo!
Aditya Raghavan. Antonia Rolfs. Marie Ram. Venkat Rao. Jeffrey Rao. Grace Reventish. Sean Recibo. Elizabeth Reynolds. Danielle Rich. Kristen Richardson. Savannah Rivers. Thera Brawler. Hogan Rose. Brooke Ross. Kayla Ross.
Again.
Colleen Rudy. Ava Russo. Nisa Salyards. Kaysen Sanju. Clara Santos. Christian Sauer. Jackson Savage. Eva Schneider. Emma Scipioni. Michaela Sims. Quinn Serpa. Bilal Shaquille. Elizabeth Sharon. Elizabeth Sai. Michael Serignano. Abigail Slatella. Seamus Slattery. Liliana Smith. Daria Smolina. Nicholas Sorger. William Sorger. Lillian Springer. Daldina St. Hubert. Bujena Stoyanchev. Maya Strelo.
Yo, Maya!
Robin Suchaleki. Matthew Sifridini. Madeline Shagru. Owen Sullivan. Peter Sullivan. Vivian Tam. Drew Tardif. Eliza Taylor. Leo Terry. Audrey Philly. Elizabeth Tian. Yiming Tian. Jessica Tian. David Tian.
David!
Sujal Timelsina. Camille Tosk. Nicholas Troiano. Amanda Tsai. Jonathan Tsao. Alexandros Titos. Daniel Chu. Christopher Vallis. Samuel Vaughn. Benjamin Wall. John Walsh. Philip Walton. Juliet Wang. Kevin Wang. Charles Ward. Zachary Watson. Lucy Watson. Calista Weissman. Thomas Welch. Michael Wentworth. Emma Westland. Henry Wheaton. Henry Wilhoit. Noah Wilson. Anna Wojcik. Nathan Wong. Caroline Chong. Anthony Zhu. Andy Yang. Jonathan Yu. Megan Yours. Catherine Yu. Vanessa Yu. Antonio Zarur. Catherine Zhang. Robert Zhang. Daniel Zhang. Grace Zhang. Nina Zhang. Eric Zhang. Baifan Shu. Daniel Zhao. Raymond Zhu. Claire Ziadi. Caroline Zidic. And Aiden Zudanak.
Please be seated. Farewell. Parents, guardians, family members, colleagues, and friends, I want to thank you so much for celebrating this special day with us. To the class of 2016, congratulations on reaching another milestone in your academic lives. We are all here tonight to celebrate each and every one of you for your achievements, your perseverance, and your efforts. Graduates, you should know that your moms and dads are very proud of you today. They have high hopes for you, and they believe in you, and you are making them proud by showing what you can do every day through your efforts. Today is an important day for you and for them. Today would be a good day to hug them and thank them for supporting you, because as much of it as this is an achievement, this is also the achievement of the people who care about you. That means your mom, your dad, your stepmom or stepdad, your grandparents, your sisters, brothers, and all the other people who care about you, including, but not limited to, your McCall teachers and staff. They want you to be your best and live up to your potential. With every year, you have become a little more independent. You had some great time this year, and maybe you had some tough times, but you did it and you succeeded. You're ready for the next step. I would simply ask that you make every effort to make next year even better. Remember that you don't have to follow the crowd. Do the right thing, even if you know no one's looking. There are great things coming. And just as your parents are proud, each one of you should feel proud of yourself.
Look how proud that train feels of you right now. How many trains have we had tonight? Anybody counting? Four? Five? Six it is. Winner.
I give it a 10.
10. Thank you, Nick. So congratulations to all the graduates, congratulations to the parents, and finally, congratulations to the teachers and everyone else who helped make our graduates reach this point today. It has been a pleasure to be your principal. You are truly a wonderful group of young men and women. Thank you.